Hello friends, welcome to the Bridge to IAS, Connecting Aspirants. This is another video from our UPSC Concepts and Terms series. And if you are watching this video for first time, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also press on the bell icon. In this video, I'm going to explain some key facts related to stupa. So here we are going to learn what is a stupa and what is its importance and what is the structure of a stupa. All right, let us enter into the video. So, what is a stupa? Simply, a stupa is a hemispherical structure and it contains relics of Buddha and his disciples. Some of the bodhisattvas, that means the persons who have attained their enlightenment but they are stopping their death, which is called Mahaparinibbana in Buddhism. And that is to guide others to their enlightenment. So such people's relics are kept in these hemispherical mounds, which are called stupas. Clear? So it is mainly used for meditation purpose. So many of the followers of Buddhism, like bhikshus and bhikshunis, they sit in these hemispherical structures and they meditate. So the main purpose is meditation. And it also has a great significance with respect to art, because many of these stupas are beautifully decorated with the panels of Jataka tails. So here, understand what is a Jataka tail. Jataka tails are tails which tells about the previous life of Buddha. So it is said that Buddha has taken many forms. So in each form, he tries to teach us some important lessons and some important values. So all those tales, they are compiled and kept as Jataka tales, and they are described with sculpturing on these stupas. And it also has many life events of Buddha, like his birth and the way he has attained his enlightenment, and the first sermon, then Mahaparinibbana, etc., have been decorated on these stupas. So what is the structure of stupa? A stupa typically has all the stupas in entire world, right? Because Buddhism has spread to many nations, particularly in the Southeast Asian nations as well, because of conquest of Ashoka and also because of many travelers. So everywhere the stupa has the following elements, structural elements. So here I am providing a three-dimensional picture. So have a look at it. The hemispherical mound which we are talking about, this mound is called anda. This is important one. So under which, so there will be a doorway to this, and here there will be meditation of many present monks, right? So important one is the anda. So next to that, circumventing this anda, there will be a vedika, right? So this railing, vedika or railing, this is also known as railing. This railing will be there. And the space between the anda and the vedika is known as pradakshana path, that is the circumventory path through which the pilgrims, the bhakts, they can circumvent this anda, right? So this is another structure. Apart from that, on the top of the anda there will be a square shaped harmika. So this one is called harmika. And this is, there will be a yasti. Yasti is a pillar kind of shaped one on which there are different umbrellas, so which are known as chatri. These are the important parts. So starting from here, vedika, that is the railing, then the pradakshana path, then anda, harmika, yasti and chatris. Apart from that, some of the stupas and their railings have been decorated with gateways which are known as toranas. So please remember, these gateways are known as toranas. So on these toranas, many sculptures like yakshas and yakshanis, dwarapalakas and many Jataka tales, the life events of Buddha, etc., have been sculptured. And because of them, they are very important with respect to the art and culture. So they are very much important for the heritage of any nation, right? And religiously, they are highly important for Buddhist community. So these are the elements of a stupa, and the importance of this stupa is mainly for meditation, and they contain the relics of Buddha, and they are very much important and very religiously very important for Buddhist community. So this is all about stupa, and if you have any doubts, do comment, and also please like and share it so that this content reaches to the maximum aspirants. And if you like my little bit of hard work, please do subscribe and share these videos among your fellow aspirants. Thank you very much.